Got some practice square root problems for you. We're going to start with this one right here. The square root of the product, 49 times 25 times 144. Now, I know you don't want to sit down and multiply that all out because that looks like a lot of work. So we're going to try to figure out how to do this without doing all that work. Huh. Those are all perfect squares. We like perfect squares and square roots because we know how to take the square root of a perfect square. Remember that back from when we first started talking about the square roots? If n is non-negative, we take the square root of n squared. That gives us n, because the square root of n squared is the number that we square in order to get n squared. That's n. So we're going to go ahead and take a look at 49, 25, and 144 as the squares of 7, 5, and 12. So we write each of those, 49, 25, and 144, as squares. Now we'd like to have just the square of one thing under the square root. So we're going to take an exponent rule here. We've got a product of squares. We can write that as the square of a product. And we've turned this into a problem we know how to handle. We know how to take the square root of a perfect square. Square root of the square of 7 times 5 times 12 is just 7 times 5 times 12. 5 times 12 is 60. 60 times 7, that's 420. And we're on to the next problem. Oh boy, I don't know what number we square to get 129,600. I don't even know if 129,600 is a perfect square. But I do know that 100 is a perfect square. So I'm going to start off by breaking this up into 1296 times 100. Because I know that 100 is a perfect square, and if I can figure out what 1296 is the square of, well, I can use the same thing we did on the last problem to finish this one. But, I don't know what number we square to get 1296. Got a product of integers, powers. We should try prime factorization. Let's try the prime factorization of 1296. And maybe we can use that to figure out what 1296 is the square of. Well, obviously it's even. We can take out a 2. So this is 2 times 648. Wow, we can take out another 2 for sure. We get 2 times 324. Now, maybe you recognize 324 is 18 squared, but if you don't, all's not lost. We can keep going with our prime factorization. This is 2 times 162. 162 is 2 times 81. Now, we definitely recognize 81 here. 81 is 9 squared, so hey, we can pair up some of these prime factors and make perfect squares. So this 2 and 2 go together, that's 2 squared. 2 and 2 goes together, that's 2 squared. And our 81, of course, that was 9 squared. So I can write my 1296 here as 2 squared times 2 squared times 9 squared. And of course, the 100 is 10 squared. So whenever I have a number I'm taking the square root of and I don't know it off the top of my head, I can use prime factorization here. And then look through the factors that I'm producing, look through those for perfect squares, and then hopefully we'll be able to write the number as a product of a bunch of perfect squares like we did right here. Now, of course, we know how to handle this. We use the same thing we did in the last problem. We write this product of perfect squares as the square of a product. Of course, we know how to take the square root of a perfect square. We'll get 2 times 2 times 9 times 10. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 9, that's 36. 36 times 10 is 360. And we're on to the next problem. Who? Well, we know how to take the square root of a perfect square, but this wants the square of a square root. Well, sometimes I see a new problem like this, I try to simplify it, try to solve a simpler version of this problem, and maybe we can use what we learned to solve this problem. Well, simple, square root of 4. We know the square root of 4. We'll try squaring that. Well, the square root of 4 is just 2, and then 2 squared is 4. All right, let's try another simple one. We'll try 9. Square root of 9, we'll take that and square it. Square root of 9 is 3. And then 3 squared, that gives us 9 back. Hey, look at that! If I square the square root of 4, I get 4. If I square the square root of 9, we get 9. So we don't have to go through prime factorization of this gigantic number, find its square root, and then square it. We know what the answer of this is going to be. We think it's just going to be that number. We're going to get that number back, but why? Well, let's see. The square root of 4, that's the number you square in order to get 4. The square root of 9, that's the number that you square in order to get 9. So if I take the square root of this giant number, I get the number that when I square it, I'll get the giant number. So I take that square root, that's the number I'm going to square to get the giant number, and then I square it. Well, of course, I'm going to get the giant number, because that's what the square root is. It's the number we square in order to get this 1,522,756. So squaring a square root is a lot like taking the square root of a square. It's a lot easier than it looks. And there's our answer, and we're on to the next problem. Almost looks like a problem we know how to solve. It almost looks like a linear equation, but then there's this square root thing here that ruins it. If there weren't that square root, we'd know what to do. If it were just 3x minus 5 equals 11, add 5 to both sides, then divide by 3, and we could solve for x. But that square root thing is in the way. So we want to turn this into a problem we know how to do. We want to turn this into a linear equation. How are we going to do that? Well, the square root of 3x minus 5 equals 11. That means that 11 is the number that we square in order to get 3x minus 5. Another way to think about that is 11 is the square root of 121. 121, of course, is 11 squared. So 3x minus 5 must be 121. Now, another way to think about this is we can think of this as squaring both sides of this equation. We square this square root here, square the square root of 3x minus 5, we'll get 3x minus 5. As long as 3x minus 5 is non-negative, we'll have to check that at the end. We square 11, we get 121. This gives us our equation that we know how to solve. We add 5 to both sides, and then we divide both sides by 3. We get x is 42. Now, of course, we solved a new type of equation here, so we definitely need to check our answer. I mean, it's usually a good idea to check our answer anyway, but especially when we're solving a new kind of equation. So we're going to take this 42, put it back in here, make sure we didn't make any mistakes. 3 times 42 minus 5. 3 times 42. 3 times 40 is 120. 3 times 2 is 6. So this is the square root of 126 minus 5. 126 minus 5 is 121. And sure enough, the square root of 121 is 11. So our answer checks out. And we're done.